Come and drink from the life-giving stream, where joy, peace, and laughter redeem. In Christ Jesus, we find our way. United in love, we sing and pray.
Hallelujah.
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 Let us close our eyes. All our intention, we can surrender to Jesus. Help me, lead me, guide me. Whatever intention we have, we can lift up to Jesus. Jesus, through the merit of Jesus, Abba Father, bless us. All our family members, we lift up to you. Protect us with your wounds. Protect us with your precious blood. Jesus, come to our midst. Lead me, my dear brothers and sisters. In the book of Samuel, we can see the prophet Samuel came to Saul and said, "The Spirit of the Lord will dwell in you powerfully, and you will become a new person." When the Spirit dwells in us, we will be automatically a new person and a new creation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. St. Luke Gospel, chapter 1, 35 verse says, "Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Angel of the Lord told to Mother Mary, God sent angels to Mother Mary. The angel said to Mother Mary, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you." Look these words. These anointing words we can make as our prayer. Whatever problem we are facing, we can say to ourselves, "Holy Spirit will come upon me. The power of the Most High will overshadow me." Such a way, whatever problem we are facing, at that time we recite this word of God, we can overcome whatever problem we are facing in our realities. The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The Holy Spirit will come upon me. The power of the Most High will overshadow you. Such a way, if you pray with Jesus, the presence of God, we can feel, experience in our life. The Acts of the Apostles, chapter 6, verses 10, we can see that Stephen was filled with the grace and power of the Holy Spirit. We also need the Holy Spirit. We also need the experience of the God's presence. In that way, we can see Acts of the Apostles, chapter 7, 55, "But he, full of the Holy Spirit, gazed to heaven and saw the glory of God." Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In the midst of the suffering, he looked to the God. He filled with the glory of God. The Second Chronicle, chapter 7 verse 1 we can see Solomon had ended his prayer, fire came down from heaven. When Solomon is praying at the end of the prayer, the fire came down from heaven and consumed the burnt offering and the sacrifice. Hallelujah. The glory of the God filled in that temple. If you pray with your house, if you pray with all our problems, the fire of the Holy Spirit will fill you and guide you and lead you. Hallelujah. The book says that Solomon prayed at that time, fire come down from heaven and consume the burnt offering. The book of the King, first book of the King, chapter 18, we can see that Elijah is praying to Jesus, answer me, O Lord, that these people may know that thou, O Lord, art God, and that thou hast turned their heart back. Hallelujah.
The
first King, chapter 18, verses 13. Look, Elijah praying at that time, fire from heaven come down. Solomon praying at that time, fire come down, the glory of God fill in the chapel. Apostles prayed with the Holy Mary. They saw tongues like flames of fire coming upon each of them. When Solomon was praying, fire came down. Elijah prayed, fire came down. Believe that your God is God, who is powerful enough to send down fire from heaven upon your prayers and prayerful intentions.
Hallelujah.
What we need is the experience of God. We should acquire that experience. God is our life. Experience of God in our life. By praying, we can experience the God's presence in our life. The first letter to John, chapter 1, we can see that. Look, these words. This is what the apostles had to say to the world. Jesus, whom we have seen with our eyes and heard with our ears, touched with our hand, and we saw it and testified to it and proclaimed to you. Hallelujah. Dear brothers and sisters, what we need is God and the experience of God's presence. How does God and the experience of God happen in our life? We must be able to experience the knowledge we have a God. For this can be answered, this how we can experience the God's presence. We have knowledge about God. We have God. We have experienced that. How we experience the knowledge of God to our personal life. If you say about sugar, it is sweet, it is white, and you can make sweet dish for that, by that. That is only in the level of the knowledge. If you put a grain of sugar on your tongue, then it will be, you can experience that. From the knowledge, that will come to our experience into our life. Hallelujah.
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 To become an experience, it is coming from the level of knowledge to the level of the experience. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We should be able to experience God through our knowledge we have about God. For that we need our personal effort. To experience of God is the personal, it is our personal experience. Behind every experience of God there is a great personal effort from our part. Rest of them will God will do. Whatever facing realities, we praying and praying, we stand in front of Jesus, that problems will be lead to the experience of God. The St. Luke chapter 2 verses 37. Look this word of God. A widow, she is 84 year old. She did not depart from the temple, worshipping with the fasting and prayer night and day. A person is standing in front of God with the prayer, with the fasting day and night, that lead to a personal experience of God. If you need a personal experience of God, you need a divine touch in your life. Through our prayers, God's intervention will come to our life. God's touch you get from your effort. God will touch you through the word of God. God will really touch you through your prayers you lift up to God. God will touch you through His Holy Spirit. In the book of the Acts, we can see that a person, he is persecuting the church as much as he could. That much persecution he is given to his church. The Acts chapter 3:8, we can see the three words. Saul, meanwhile, was trying to destroy the church, entering house after house and dragging out men and women and handed them over for imprisonment. Hallelujah.
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 He persecuting the church as much as he could, that much he persecuting the church, entering the house and dragging out men and women and handed them over for prison, imprisonment. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Believers, what they do, the believers, the believers continue to pray for Saul's repentance. The Acts chapter 9, verse 1, we can see that Saul still breathing murderous threat against the disciples of the Lord. Hallelujah.
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 Prayer is the power. The master's touch descended in Saul's life. An enemy of the church, he became propagandist of the church. Who was the enemy of Jesus became the friend of Jesus. That much change happened in the life of Saul. With the master's touch, totally changed Saul's life. The Acts chapter 9, 3 onwards. Acts chapter 9, verse 3. Hallelujah.
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 The believers, from the depth of heart, they prayed to Saul's repentance. The prayer reached up to God's presence. God's intervention come to Saul's life. On his journey, as he was nearing to Damascus, a light from the sky suddenly flashed around him. He fell to ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. Master's touch changed Saul's life. The enemy of the church became propagandist of the church. Who was the enemy of Jesus become the friend of Jesus. Hallelujah. God looked Saul's vision. God took Saul's vision and changed his life drastically. Why God took his vision? The verse 8 we can see Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he could not see nothing. Why did the Lord take Saul's eyes? If Saul could see, he would have run away. Some problems or some life situation that forces us to reach to God. Hallelujah. God kept Saul blind for many days because Saul would see what he saw and hear what he heard that will make him a new creation. Some problems in our life also, if we look to our life, if you look to our family, there is some problem is there. That problem lead to experience to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. 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 God kept Saul blind for many days because Saul would see what he saw and hear what he heard that will make him a new creation. Hallelujah. A girl was bedridden. She was affected by polio. She could not move her arms and her legs. He always prayed that if there is a God in the world, give me grace to know and experience that God. That girl would pray to God every day like that. One day at night, a great light filled his room, and that light changed into human form, and human form said to her, I am Jesus Christ, I am healing you. It seemed to her like a dream she had in the middle of the night. She slept soundly that night. When she wake up in the morning, she can move her legs, she can move her arms, she can sit up, she can walk around the room. She's jumping up and down and saying, Jesus touched me, Jesus visited me. The whole family entered into joy. A great miracle happened in that family. A person who has been laying down so long get up and walk. For her, it is an indescribable divine experience. She had to pay high price to stay that belief. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stretch out your hand, say loudly, Hallelujah. 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 Whatever we are facing problems, continuously we lift up to Jesus through your prayers. God's time will come for like a miracle. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God's time, up to the God's time, all the problems we need to lift up to Jesus. The book of Job, chapter 22, verse 25, we can see that. If you need lift up your problems, we need the Almighty is your gold and your precious silver, then you will delight yourselves in the Almighty. Hallelujah.
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 If the Almighty is your gold and your precious silver, then you will delight yourself in the Almighty. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That much you love your God, that much you trust in your God, then only God's miracle come into our life. The Acts of the Apostles chapter 12, we can see that King Herod killed James by the sword, and the king saw that it was pleasing the Jews, he proceed to arrest Peter also. It was the feast of the unleavened bread. He had him taken into custody and put in prison. Under the guard of four soldiers each, he intended to bring him before the people after Passover. Peter thus was kept in prison, but the prayers by the church was fervently being made to God on behalf of Peter. Church members continuously praying to Jesus for Peter on the very night before Herod was bring him to trial. Peter, secured by double chain, was sleeping between the two soldiers. While outside the door, God kept watch on the prison. Suddenly, angel of the Lord stood by him, and a light shone in the cell. He tapped Peter on the side and awakened him, saying, "Get up quickly." The chains fell from his wrist. Angel said to him, "Put your belt and your sandals," and he did so. Then he said to him, "Put on your cloak and follow me." So he followed him out, not realizing that what was happening through the angels was real. He thought he was seeing a vision. They passed the first guard, then the second, and came to the iron gate leading out to the city, which was opened for them by itself. They emerged and made their way down an alley, and suddenly the angel left it to him. Then Peter recovered his sense and said, "Now I know for certain that Lord sent his angels and rescued me." Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All the congregation prayed for Peter. God's hand reached out to prison. God sent his angels and miraculously rescued Peter from prison. Prayer is the power of our life. If you pray non-stop prayer, you start all our problems, you will get answer from the heaven. Hallelujah.
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 Why be not getting answer from heaven? Because we are praying, we are not getting, we will stop our prayers. We never will again start our prayer. We started prayer without getting, we will stop, we will go our own way. God's blessing will not come. If you not get answer to your prayers, you need to continually, you need to pray for that intention up to the intervention from heaven. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That much faith you need, then only God's answer will come to you. Most probably our prayer will be breaking some days after. So God's blessing is not come to our prayer intention. Hallelujah.
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 The book of the St. Paul's letter to Ephesians chapter 3 verses 20 we can see. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20. Hallelujah.
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 Through the sacraments, one power, great power is in us. That power is active through our prayers. Look this word, who is able to accomplish far more than all we ask or imagine by the power at work within us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What reality we do face. Are you able to raise all that before God as God wants? Then only God's presence come to our midst. Prayer is the power of our life. We should find time in God's presence to raise our problems for the God's intervention. God will do great miracle through your prayers. When the whole community began to pray for Saul, who was persecuting them, they were able to see God's miracle. In the whole congregation prayed for Peter in prison, God's touch came to him in prison. Whatever problem is troubling you, you have succeeded in raising it to God and as God want it. Hallelujah.
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 What is the problem you are facing? That you raise up to Jesus as God want it. Such a zealous mind we need, dear brothers and sisters. Our life being God expecting from us continuously, trust and praying, he surrender all our realities in front of Jesus. Look to the life of Saint Augustine. How a man who lived in sinful life became a saint. Saint Augustine's mother Monica was a person of prayerful life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
She prayed with the tears so many years for her son's repentance. Seeing the mother's tears, prayer, Saint Ambrose, the bishop of that era, tell the mother that son of tears will not be lost. Not that much pain she gave to the repentance of his son. Years and years, with the tears of prayer, she continued. What happened? God's time came. God's touch specially came down to Saint Augustine. One day his mother Monica brought a Bible in his room. When he see that Bible sitting on his table, he take that holy Bible and throw it away. The Bible fall before him like an open book. At that time he hears a voice, take the holy Bible and read it. The passage opened before the Augustine was the letter of the Saint Paul, Romans chapter 13 verses 11 and 12. Saint Augustine's mother's prayer. She prayed with the tears so many years. The God's time came and God's touch came upon him. It is the hour now for you to awake from sleep, for our salvation is nearer, not than when we first believed. The night is advanced, the day is at hand. Let us then throw off the work of the darkness, put on the arm of light. Hallelujah.
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 This word of God really touch. That's spoken for Augustine only. That word of God spoken only for Augustine. That word pierced his heart. The word of God that God gave Augustine to be a Saint Augustine. That word of God changed Augustine's life drastically. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Augustine became Saint Augustine. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Definitely a great intervention of the Lord come to our life. Believe it. Non-stop prayer you start in your life. You receive great blessing from our Lord Jesus Christ through prayer, through Holy Mass, reading Bible, reciting Holy Rosary. You will definitely get an experience of God in your life. The Luke Gospel chapter 10:27 says that you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your strength, and with all your mind. God say to us, you love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your strength, and with all your mind. No matter what problem is in front of us, when we start calling on God with all our heart, God's intervention will happen in due time. Hallelujah. Book of the Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3, we can see that. Look, that word of God, call to me, I will answer you. I will tell you things great beyond reach of your knowledge. Continuously pray and surrender all our realities. And if you wait for God's time, you will see the God's miracle. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When I was in India, we have so many retreat centers are there. In the one of the retreat center, when I take charge in that retreat center, a small girl came to me. She said, Father, please pray for me. I said to her, please kneel down. I will put my hand on your head. You please start praising Jesus. That girl began to praise Jesus, heavenly praise coming from her heart. Slowly she start praising. That lead to a heavenly praising coming from her heart. I asked that child, when you got such a grace? She was prayer group member in that retreat center. The leader of that prayer group gave an instruction. We have only 9 days for our convention. How many of you can recite every day, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus? That girl, every day morning to evening, before the Blessed Sacrament, he began to pray, saying, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus. After that, in her house, before the Sacred Heart, she prayed, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus. By the end of the 9 days, she prayed 1,25,000 times. She prayed, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus. Hallelujah. She told me after 19 lakh time, her prayer, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus, she felt some other languages were changing, coming, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus, prayer is coming with other languages. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Great power from above has descended from heaven on that child who prays, calling, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus. That girl's prayer helped me to think a lot, moved my life, and surprised me. I went to Adoration Chapel with a great desire. I kneel and lift up my hand and I cry out, Oh my Jesus, Oh my Jesus. If I call one hour, oh my Jesus, oh my Jesus, how many time can I call? I started praying and prayed exactly 1 hour. And I realized that in 1 hour, I can pray 3,500 times. If we continuously pray, oh my Jesus, oh my Jesus, with 1 hour, we can recite 3,500 times. I went to my room and calculated how long time needed for that, for 1 crore, 1,25,000 time. I calculated that if you spent at least 1 day 15 hours, then only you can call that much time. I think that how much that girl paid for that. That much he gave time to Jesus. Oh my Jesus, oh my Jesus, morning to evening, and evening to how much time he get, that much time he spend every day, at least 18 hours he spend the oh my Jesus prayer continuously 19 days. God's touch came down from heaven and he are blessed with a prayerful life. Hallelujah. The Acts of the Apostles chapter 4:12 says that there is no salvation through anyone else, nor in there any other name under heaven given the human race by which we are to be saved. Hallelujah. St. Luke chapter 24:49. Jesus Christ gave to his disciples the instruction is that I am sending the promise of my Father upon you. Only one condition, but stay in the city until you are clothed with the power of the high, power from on high. We need to spend time every day to get an experience from God. If you want God's grace, sit in front of God. If you need to consolation to get from Jesus, you spend some time in front of Jesus. You attend Holy Mass. You read Word of God. You please recite Rosary. Never God will abandon you. What blessing will come to you? Whatever intention you have, you sit in front of Jesus. If you sit in front of Jesus, then only God's blessing you can receive only. In the Gospel of the Luke, there is a saying about Anna, who never left the temple and prayed to God. We read early, she never left the temple, but worshipped night and day with fasting and prayer. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The book of the Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of the God was kept there. He was in the presence of the God. He heard the voice of the word of God. Look, dear brothers and sisters, if you spend some time in front of Jesus, that will transform you. That will convert you a new person. Whatever problem is you have, all will be God's blessing. You will delivered by God's presence. In the absence of the Jesus, the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, they were living in secret. That transformed their life. They realized that they have no one. They call upon the Lord from the bottom of the heart. Jesus came to her midst God's grace will come to those who call on his name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The science proved one thing. In this world, those who are keep time for prayer, from them there is a great magnetic power is flowing to the world. Those who are keeping prayer, they are sitting in front of Jesus. From them, the magnetic power is flowing to all your intentions. If you keep prayer in your home, that home atmosphere is filled with the magnetic power. If you kept some time before the altar or Blessed Sacrament, whatever intention you are standing there, the magnetic power is flows all to the intention. Hallelujah. But we need a heavenly touch in our life. Our master's touch we need. That will lead you. That solve all the problems what we are facing in our life. Whenever you get a touch from God, that much time you spend in front of Jesus, really you will be a person of prayer. The Spirit will come upon you. The power of the Most High will overshadow you. Angel told to Mother Mary, Holy Spirit will come upon you. The power of the Most High will overshadow you. Apostles prayed with the Holy Mother. They saw tongues like flame of fire coming upon each of them. While Solomon was praying, fire came down from heaven and consumed the offering. Elijah prayed, fire came down from heaven and received the sacrifice. Believe that your God is God, who is powerful enough to send down fire from heaven upon your prayers. Whatever intention we have, experience of God is personal. The personal effort we need to experience our God. We can surrender all our life like an open book. Jesus, help me. We should be able to experience the God through our prayer. All our intention we can lift up to Jesus. Give me your touch. Give me your experience. Give me your presence. We can praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Je, mnaamini katika muungano wa watakatifu? Praise the Lord. How many of you do believe the union of all the saints? And do you believe that, je, mnaamini kwamba kama ukiomba kwa mtakatifu, nasakana mimi naitwa Padri Biju, jina la ubatizo wangu ni Anthony. Praise the Lord. You know, as I am standing here in the presence of the Eucharistic Lord, Saint Anthony is here with me. He is interceding for me. Father Lindo, that is the name, and his baptismal name is Stephen, isn't it? Saint Stephen, the first martyr, he is here with him and he is interceding for him. What is the name of your patron saint? Maybe some of you may belong to other denomination, maybe you don't have your patron saint. You don't worry, And now, my dear brothers and sisters, on behalf of all of you, on behalf of all our family members, even those who maybe they are not Catholics, on behalf of them, we are now invoking, we are going to ask the intercession of all the saints. Let us say amen.
Amen.
And as we are praying, as we are asking their intercession, each one of them, they will come and they will be standing close to you. Wanasimama karibu nawe na tena na maombezi ya watakatifu. Leo sisi tunasipokea baraka nyingi kutoka Mwenyezi Mungu. Let us ask the intercession of all the saints. We pray, Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously heal us.
God the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Saint Gabriel,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael,
pray for us.
All you holy angels and archangels,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
All you holy patriarchs and prophets,
pray for us.
Saint Peter,
pray for us.
Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint James the Greater,
pray for us.
Saint John the Apostle,
pray for us.
Saint Thomas,
pray for us.
Saint James the Less,
pray for us.
Saint James,
pray for our families.
Saint Philip,
pray for our families.
Saint Bartholomew,
pray for our families.
Saint Matthew,
pray for our families.
Saint Simon,
pray for our families.
Saint Jude,
pray for our families.
Saint Matthias,
pray for our families.
Saint Barnabas,
pray for our families.
Saint Luke,
pray for our families.
Saint Mark,
pray for our families.
All you holy apostles and evangelists,
pray for our families.
All you holy disciples of the Lord,
pray for our families.
All you holy innocents,
pray for our families.
Saint Stephen,
pray for our families.
Saint Lawrence, pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Vincent de Paul,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Fabian and Sebastian,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint John and Paul of the Cross,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Maximilian Kolbe,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Francis de Sales,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Francis of Assisi,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Cosmas and Damian,
pray for our country Kenya.
All you holy martyrs,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Sylvester,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Gregory the Great,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Leo the Great,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Pius the 10th,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint John the 23rd,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint John Paul the 2nd,
pray for the country Kenya.
Saint Ambrose,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Augustine,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Jerome,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Martin de Porres,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint George,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint John Henry Newman,
pray for our country Kenya.
Saint
Nicholas Lu.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Bruno Sarunkuma.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Christopher.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Patrick.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Charles Borromeo.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Chabel MacLeod.
Pray for our country Kenya.
All you holy bishops and confessors.
Pray for our country Kenya.
All you holy doctors.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Anthony of Padua.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Benedict.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Bernard.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Dominic of the Rosary.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Padre Pio.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint John Biani.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint John Bosco.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Gerard Majella.
Pray for our country Kenya.
Saint Kuriakos Elias Shavara.
Pray for our country Kenya.
We pray, pray for all the sick.
Saint Daniel Komboni.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Joseph of Cupertino.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Juan Diego.
Pray for all the sick.
All you holy priests and Levites.
Pray for all the sick.
All you holy monks and hermits.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Teresa of Avila.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Teresa of Calcutta.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Mary Magdalene.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Monica.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Margaret Mary Alacoque.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Bernadette.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Maria Goretti.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint Bridget of Sweden.
Pray for all the sick.
Saint John of the Ark.
Pray for all the sick. Pray for all the jubilees.
Saint Julia.
Pray for all the jubilees.
Saint Agatha.
Pray for all the jubilees.
Saint Lucy.
Pray for all the jubilees.
Saint Rose of Lima.
Pray for all the jubilees.
Saints Perpetua and Felicity.
Pray for all the jubilees.
Saint Fortini.
Pray for all the jubilees.
Saint Mariam Theresia.
Pray for all the
Saint Euphrasia. Saint Elizabeth.
Pray for all the jobless.
Saint Agnes.
Pray for all the jobless.
Saint Cecilia.
Pray for all the jobless.
Saint Anastasia.
Pray for all the jobless.
Saint Alfonsa.
Pray for all the jobless.
Saint Catherine of Siena.
Pray for all the jobless.
Saint Claire of Assisi.
Pray for all the jobless.
Saint Rita.
Pray for all the jobless.
All you holy virgins and widows.
Pray all the jobless.
All you holy saints of God.
Pray for all the jobless.
All you holy martyrs of Uganda, most firm and faithful to Christ and His church.
Pray for all the jobless.
We pray, pray for Africa.
Saint Charles Luanga.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Matthias Kalemba Mulumba.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Joseph Mukasa.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Denis Sebugwao.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Poncian Gondwe.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Ambrose Katekamu.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Mukasa Kiriwawanvu.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Andrew Kagwa.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Athanasius Bazekuketa.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Gonzaga Gonza.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Noi Mawagali.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Luke Banabakintu.
Pray for Africa.
Saint James Buzabaluayo.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Giavira Mayanja Musoke.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Anatolias Kirigwajo.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Achilles Kiwanuka.
Pray for Africa.
Zito.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Baga Tuzinde.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Mugaga Lubowa.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Mukasa Aldofas Ludigo.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Bruno Serenkuma.
Pray for Africa.
Saint John Maria Muzei.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Jose Maria Escriva.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Josephine Bakita.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Anne and Joachim.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Faustina Kowalska.
Pray for Africa.
Saint Louis and Zeni Martin.
Pray for Africa.
Let us pray. Lord, save this world. Lord, save this world.
Lord, save this world.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, save this world
from all evil.
Lord, save this world
from all sin.
Lord, save this world
from your wrath.
Lord, save this world
from a sudden and unprovided death.
Lord, save this world.
Now we pray, Lord, save your people.
Lord, save your people
from the snares of the devil.
Lord, save your people
from anger, hatred and all ill will.
Lord, save your people
from the spirit of uncleanness.
Lord, save your people
from lightning and tempest.
Lord, save your people
from the scourge of earthquake.
Lord, save your people
from plague, famine and war.
Lord, save your people
from everlasting death.
Lord, save your people
by the mystery of your holy incarnation.
Lord, save your people
by your coming.
Lord, save your people
by your birth.
Lord, save your people
by your baptism and holy fasting.
Lord, save your people
by your cross and passion.
Lord, save your people
by your death and burial.
Lord, save your people
by your holy resurrection.
Lord, save your people
by your wonderful ascension.
Lord, save your people
by the coming of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, save your people
on the day of judgment.
Lord, save your people.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Let's pray. We pray together. O Lord Jesus Christ,
you have wonderfully strengthened the holy saints. You have given them to us an
examples of faith and fortitude,
chastity,
charity and fidelity.
We beseech you that by their intercession
the same virtues may increase in us, and that we too may deserve to become propagators of true faith. You who live and reign with God the Father and God the Holy Spirit,
world without end, we pray. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's pray. Hallelujah.
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 My dear brother, my dear sister, as we are longing for God the Holy Spirit, as we are longing for the anointing of the Holy Spirit, as we are praying for the gifts, fruits and charisms of the Holy Spirit, God the Holy Spirit is reminding us one thing. As you are standing in the presence of the Lord, if you are standing in the presence of the Lord with the spirit of hatred or unforgiveness, bitterness, anger, revenge against your brothers and sisters, you need to forgive them. You need to forgive them. Kama mnasimama hapa mbele ya uwepo wa Mwenyezi Mungu, Mungu anatukumbusha kwamba ni muhimu kabisa kwamba wasamehe wale wote wamekukosea. Wapendwa, sisi tupo leo hapa tuombea kwa Mungu wetu, na vile vile tuombeane. Naomba, now let us pray for one another. and your brother, your sister, she needs your assistance. Now we pray for one another, and if there is any root of bitterness, resentment, hatred, revenge in you, kindly let us forgive. Let us forgive and pray for them. Now, even you can, maybe you can stand face to face now. We pray for one another. We stand face to face. Naomba tusimame ni uso kwa uso, kama mimi ni padri, tumesimama hivi uso kwa uso. Kama wewe ni peke yako, naomba kujiunga kwenye kikundi cha watu wawili. Hakuna mtu anasimama peke yako. Sasa naomba pia moja wapo niweza kupiga magoti mbele yake. Moja kupiga magoti mbele yake. Sasa mtu ambaye anasimama, onyesha ni mkono yote miwili juu ya kaka yako, juu ya dada yako. Mkono yote miwili akone aje ya kugusa. No need of touching her. You can just stretch out your both hands upon your brother, upon your sister. All those who are standing, close your eyes now. And you try to remember all those people offended you, hurt you, sexually abused you, pregnanted you and threw you out. One who borrowed money and never ever given back that money to you. One who cheated you. One who destroyed your family life. Wapendwa, wakumbukeni wale wote wamekukosea. Niwasagana yule ambaye amekubebesha mimba na amekuacha. Yule ambaye niwasakana alikupesha hela mpaka leo bado hajazirudisha zile hela. Yule ambaye niwasakana amekumisa kabisa kupitia maneno yake. Yule ambaye aliharibu familia. Yule ambaye akamchukua mume wako au mke. Sasa wapendwa, tuombe wale wote. Niwasakana baba, niwasakana mama, niwasakana shangazi, niwasakana mjomba, mtu ambaye amekukosea. Kumbuka wale wote, wale ambao wanasimama, wakumbukeni maadui yako, na wasamehe, waombee. Wakati huu ni wakati wa uponyaji. Wakati huu, wakati wa msamaha. Wakati huu Yesu anayepangusa machozi yako. Na tena wakati huu uchawi wa adui yote kwa jina la Yesu sasa itaondoka kabisa kutoka maisha yako, kutoka familia. Wale ambao wanapiga magoti, kama if you have offended anyone, if you hurt anyone, ask God's mercy and forgiveness. And now all those who are standing, you may pray for your enemies and forgive them. Pray for your enemies and forgive them. Now, as we are shouting the name of Jesus, as we are calling out the name of Jesus, Jesus is coming to you. Maybe you are blocked to receive God's blessing. Maybe the block is unforgiveness. Maybe your block is the spirit of revenge. Maybe that is blocking to receive God's blessings in your life. Maybe you are sick and you need God's healing. Maybe the block might be the spirit of revenge, unforgiveness and hatred. My dear brother, my dear sister, let us pray and let us ask God's mercy. Let us forgive our enemies. Now call out the name of Jesus. As we call out that name, Jesus is coming to you. He is going to touch you. He is going to bless you. He is going to deliver you. He is going to wipe away your tears. And He is going to heal your sicknesses. Now, all of us, let us pray for our enemies. Kwa sauti yako yote, sasa mwita jina la Yesu. Yesu.
Yesu. Yesu.
Kwa sauti, kila moja.
Yesu. 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 Yesu.
Holy name.
Yesu.
Forgive.
Yesu.
Samehe.
Yesu.
Baba.
Yesu.
Baba yako.
Yesu. Yesu.
Watoto.
Yesu.
Majirani.
Yesu. Yesu. Yesu.
Marafiki.
Yesu.
Wale wote.
Yesu.
Kulia.
Yesu.
Samehe.
Yesu. Yesu. Yesu
kwa machozi
Yesu Yesu
Yesu anapita
Yesu
anagusa watu wake
Yesu 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 Yesu
Yesu
Yesu Yesu Yesu Yesu Yesu
forgive them
Yesu
forgive
Yesu Yesu
Yesu
Yesu
wabariki
Yesu
wasamehe
Yesu
wasamehe
Yesu
kwa jina la
Yesu
Yesu wasamehe
Yesu
kwa jina la
Yesu Yesu
wasamehe
Yesu Yesu Yesu
Yesu Yesu Yesu mwite Yesu Yesu anayepangua machozi yako, machozi ya kushinda msamaha, machozi ya uchungu. Yesu anayepangusa na Yesu anayobariki, Yesu anayoponya watu wake. Sasa naomba tuendelee tuombe, tuwasamehe, tusameheane. Now all those who are standing, wale ambao wanasimama, naomba kuinua kake yako, dada yako, na kuinua yeye. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wale wote walikuwa wanasimama, kama inawezekana unaweza kupiga magoti mbele yake. Wale wote walikuwa wamesimama, naomba unaweza kupiga magoti mbele ya kaka yako, mbele ya dada yako. Naomba weka tu mkono juu ya kaka na juu ya dada yako, anahitaji maombi yako. Wale wote wanasimama sasa, wakumbukeni wale wote wamekukosea. Nasakana baba, nasakana mama, shangazi, mjomba, mume au mke wako, watoto, majirani, wale ambao walikuwa wanafanya kazi na wewe. Wapendwa, muda huu ni muda wa baraka, muda huu ni muda wa uponyaji. Sasa naomba tuendelee kuombea, kuwasamehe wale wote. Naomba sasa tumite jina la Yesu, na ili tupate uponyaji, tupate amani moyoni. Sasa naomba mwite jina la Yesu. Yesu, Yesu,
Yesu,
kila moja.
Yesu, Yesu, Yesu.
Kwa machozi.
Yesu.
Tuombe.
Yesu.
Wale wote.
Yesu.
Wamekukosea.
Yesu. Yesu. Yesu.
Grandparents.
Yesu. Yesu.
Your parents.
Yesu.
Your brothers.
Yesu.
Your sisters.
Yesu. Yesu. Yesu, 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 Yesu,
the holy name of Jesus,
Yesu,
the holy name of Jesus, forgiveness,
Yesu,
the holy name of Jesus, reconciliation,
Yesu,
the holy name of Jesus,
Yesu,
reconciliation,
Yesu, 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 Yesu
Forgive your dad, your mom. Forgive your children. Forgive your unfaithful husbands, your wife. Forgive your brothers and sisters. This moment of grace and blessing, and God is healing many of you right now, and God is blessing many of you right now. God is blessing you with the spirit of forgiveness, and God is blessing you with the spirit of reconciliation. Now, my dear brother, my dear sister, maybe you can raise your brother, your sister. Sasana omba kuinua yule ambaye anapiga magoti mbele yake. Mbele yako weka tu shari ya msalaba kwenye paji la uso wake, kwenye paji la uso wako. Mwambie Yesu akupenda, tusameheane. Let us turn to Jesus. Let us give a mighty clap to the living God. Mighty clap to the living God. Mighty, mighty clap to the living God. Mighty, mighty clap to the living God. Mighty, mighty cloud. Now we are going to sing Yesu akupenda. Sawa? Sio kwamba unasimama kama nguzo, hapana. Tunatakiwa kuimba na kucheza, sawa? Mwambie Yesu akupenda, unaonyesha hivi upande wa kulia na kushoto. Yesu atupenda bega kwa bega, na Yesu anipenda kama hivi. Sawa? Aya, tuende sasa. Makofi na vigelegele.
Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Jesus.
Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Jesus loves you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord Jesus loves you.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord Jesus
Makofi
loves you.
Bega ko bega. Bega ko bega.
Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu.
Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda.
Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu.
Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda. Yesu atupenda.
Hallelujah.
Zum sing for Yesu atupenda.
Hallelujah.
Zum sing for Yesu atupenda.
Hallelujah.
Zum sing for Yesu atupenda.
Hallelujah.
Zum sing for
Yesu atupenda.